Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Rob Blanchflower Connected Franchise or Connected Career Series here in Madden 15 on the Xbox One. Blanchflower and the Pittsburgh Steelers have started this season out 2-0. This is his second season now, as the first was pretty much spent as the third string tight end, not getting on the field very much, and they only won 3 games total in that year, but they bounce back here in the 2015 season with a 2-game winning streak to start things out. They're going to play the 1-1 New York Jets, and it's going to be a home game for the Steelers. So we'll have to see how much playing time Rob gets out there with the offense. So let's go to the field here, Heinz Field, and get ready for kickoff. The Jets are ready. And who will they be playing at quarterback? Well, we'll have to take a look in a second here. We've got Ben Roethlisberger going our way. But it's James Avery, 1 touchdown and 3 interceptions. Not a very good start for him, but that's who will be quarterbacking the Jets offense. Here comes Roethlisberger throwing this one out to Blanchflower. He's going to make the catch. It was 2nd and long. He'll get some of that yardage back. It'll be 3rd and 8 after that catch, so he gets about 6 yards. On the modest play, 3rd and 8, they got play action, and Ben's going to hit his man at the sideline. 1st down and more for John Carlson, the starting tight end. That'll be 1st and 10 Steelers. And here we go, about 4 minutes left in the first quarter, and dropping back to pass again. He's going for Blanchflower. He got up there and got a hand on it, but cannot hang on in traffic. Would have been a spectacular catch, but instead it just goes incomplete. So here a 16-10 lead for the Steelers. That pass is going to go for a 1st down. We're just jumping around to times that Blanchflower is actually out there. You think they'd go 2 tight end sets more often than they really do, but it's a little frustrating not finding the field as much as you'd like to here if you're Rob Blanchflower. They're not going his way a whole lot yet, but let's see what we got on this 1st and 10 play. They're going to throw underneath, and that's going to be a touchdown. No, they say just short, as that is Jennings, Greg Jennings, taking it to the goal line. Now play action, and it's a touchdown. There it is, the first career touchdown catch in Rob Blanchflower's career. Okay, didn't have a whole lot going up until this point, but that is a very big development right there in the career of one young Rob Blanchflower. The pride of the UMass Minutemen has struck for the first time as far as a touchdown in the NFL. He'll definitely keep that football. As far as celebrations, not right yet. Look at this catch. He is free, and oh, if he had not been bumped out of bounds, he might have had his 2nd touchdown of the day. Roethlisberger found him and led him to the point where he could turn up the sideline, but he was just bumped out of bounds. Big play, however. 3rd and 3. How about another big play? That's going to be a 1st down conversion. Ben starting to lean on the tight end a little bit more, seeing what he can do. How about another big catch? 1st and goal as the 3rd quarter will expire. Okay, it's 36-17 Pittsburgh now. Here's a long pass. It's going to go for a touchdown to Antonio Brown. And yes, the dance is on. Antonio Brown scores and runs this up here. It's going to be 42-17, and it'll be 43-17 after an extra point attempt. But Antonio Brown wide open on the play and scores easily. There you go, getting his dance on. So 43-24, just a few seconds left in this game. How about another pass to Blanchflower? It's going to be 1st and goal, and there'll be a timeout there. But I think they end up just downing that, and there is your big-time victory for the Pittsburgh Steelers. So what started as a bit of a slow day of action increased rapidly for Blanchflower later on in this ballgame, and we'll see his catch totals after we wrap things up here. But there it was, his 1st NFL touchdown, and he acted like, yep, been here before, even though he hadn't. He had every right to go crazy and celebrate. Instead, he just runs to the sideline with the football. So Ben Roethlisberger, how about having a day? 37 for 48, 467 yards. How many touchdowns did he throw? Oh, let's see here. Just 5 of them. 5 touchdowns for Roethlisberger. What a big fantasy day for him, huh? Antonio Brown, 10 catches for 121 yards. Now, Blanchflower, 6 for 75. Way to go, bud. Not only that, but his 1st NFL touchdown. That was quite a moment to remember right there, and he had some nice catches to go along with that. 6 of them in total for 75 yards. Rob Blanchflower making his stamp on the offense right here and hoping to continue to do so all season long. So they get the victory and they go to 3-0. With that third win, they've matched the win total from last season already, a disastrous season where they only won 3 games, and they've done that after 3 games played here this year. So they go into the bye week, an early bye week for the Steelers in week 4, about as early as you can get one. So the bye week will just be spent with game planning, getting the XP built up for Rod Blanchflower. I've been putting it towards his consistency lately because that means he'll earn more XP each time you go into the game planning. So we're bumping that up to speed up the amount that he'll get each time. So we do a little bit of that. He's still a 75 overall, and he's still the second string tight end. Now remember, John Carlson, I believe, is at about an 82 overall. So there's a long way to go to catch him still. And we got our next game against the Cincinnati Bengals. They're 1-3, but this is a road game, and it is a rivalry game. So let's see how this goes. The Bengals spanked us last year a couple times. So there will be no overlooking of this team, especially when you got to go to their house and get it done. Let's see if Blanchflower gets as many opportunities this week to make his presence felt in the offensive game plan. 2nd and 10 right now. They're going to throw to Antonio Brown. He kind of kicks that one around, incomplete. Nothing doing right there. We're deep into the second quarter now. 10-0 Cincinnati. Play action, but he's not looking Blanchflower's way. They will go to John Carlson instead and get 1st and goal. So good decision, I guess. 2nd and goal now. The pass to Blanchflower makes the catch in traffic, and he's down to the 2-yard line. Cannot punch it in, but does get right down on the doorstep. 3rd and goal, and Ben is going to go down with the sack. There's an injury. I don't believe it's Roethlisberger. It looks like it's a defender. Looks like it is Moats that's down for Cincinnati, so they'll have to tend to him. It's 10-6 now in the third quarter. Ben is throwing for a 1st down to Antonio Brown. Going to drop back and throw again. And this one is meant for Blanchflower, but they cannot connect. He reached for it, couldn't grab it. And that's really all he sees for action on the field. The Steelers not able to win this game. They drop it 20-12 on the road. I really wasn't amused at how little they used Blanchflower on the field today. Now, as the second string tight end, you'd think you'd be seeing a lot of 2 tight end sets where he'd be on the field. And not so much. Really not as much as you would think you would see from a team like the Pittsburgh Steelers. So Roethlisberger's day, 32 of 56. He threw 56 times for 340 yards, but no touchdowns. All they could manage was 4 field goals. As far as our boy Rob Blanchflower, just 1 catch for 6 yards. You saw it. And that's all he was able to contribute here. A lot of it because he just wasn't on the field a whole lot. Maybe they'll have to go back to the drawing board as far as game plan and see how they were able to involve him and get good use out of him in some of their wins. Well, they're going to have to kind of evaluate that going into the next game against the Cleveland Browns. The Browns, let's flip the calendar, there you go, are 3-2, and it's going to be another road game for the Steelers, so we'll have to see how this goes if we can win away from home. And so hopefully they'll involve Blanchflower more in this game. Well, we're about ready to get out there to Cleveland, to the Dog Pound, to First Energy Stadium. And I think we'll be taking on Johnny Football. I think I remember seeing him here. Of course, we don't get to watch the offense go for the other team, so we never quite know. But he is warming up right there, Johnny Manziel on the sideline. And, of course, Ben Roethlisberger warming up for the Steelers. So let's go. Let's have another one of those 5 touchdown performances, shall we? Play action. Throws behind Blanchflower, but he does adjust nicely and make the catch. There you go. Involve him early. Get him going in a rhythm. That might be good. 3rd and inches. We're obviously going to call for a run right here because that's the responsible thing to do. And even though it means not a chance to catch a ball for Blanchflower, now he had a chance at the goal line there, but they go to Le'Veon Bell instead, and he is stopped for a loss. They're going to have to kick a field goal now. And that should tie the game up at 3. It's 10-3 Cleveland now, and about 2.5 minutes before halftime. Nice stretch and a catch right there by Blanchflower. Able to grab that one as it wasn't right at him, but he's able to adjust to make the catch. But would you believe that would be his last catch of the game? Yeah, he has 2 this time. But look at, they get creamed. 33-12, the Browns. Yeah, it was a close game till later on, and then the Browns just took it to them right at the end. Not good for the Steelers. So after starting out 3-0, they now lose 2 in a row. They lost some momentum with that bye week, and that's unfortunate. But they're going to have to regroup and find a way to get Blanchflower on the field more. Well, from our standpoint, that's what we're looking for. He gets 2 catches for 19 yards. We obviously want to see him out there more. It kind of puts me in a position where when he gets out on the field, I almost have to call no huddle to keep him on the field if I want to get anything going in a game. And even then, you know, it kind of takes you away from the play calling you really want to do. You want to have some run and some pass, but if they're not going to have him on the field much, it kind of is an issue where you got to keep running the plays that will involve him, even if the situation doesn't necessarily call for it. These are things that won't be an issue once he's a starter, but right now it is. I just thought when he was a second-string tight end, you'd be seeing a lot more of opportunities for 2 tight end sets, and unless you call it, apparently, they don't really go that way. But the next game will be against the 1-5 Ravens. It's another road game, but this should be a winnable game. We'll have to come out and give it a good effort. We'll see you next time for more Rob Blanchflower. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.